Welcome, everybody, to another presentation of the NBA Live on 2K Sports. I'm Kevin Harlan, joined by Chris Webber and Greg Anthony. David Aldridge is our sideline reporter. Last game for the Hornets, they picked up the W against the Pistons in Detroit.
Away from home, you got to execute, and they did that flawlessly.
Yeah, and they also controlled the pace of the game for most of the night. Outstanding effort in a hostile environment.
And with the long season ahead, for the best teams, Chris, you get the feeling they wish the playoffs could start tomorrow.
Yeah, I mean, didn't we see that with Golden State last year? It looked like they were a little bored during the season.
Right.
But what happens during the playoff season? That's why we call it two different seasons. But once you reach that elite level, Kevin, everything you do is geared toward winning a championship. Everything you do. And so that's why it's so fun watching the best of the best.
The Golden State showed that, of course, last year. So let's take a look at the Charlotte starting lineup. Williams is down low with Zeller. Jeremy Lamb out there with Kemba Walker. And it's Batum in at the three slot. Now here's Lamb. On the wing, Williams, covered by Nance. Six to shoot. Outside, Batum. It's good from long range. Batum's got himself on the board with three there.
Well, that just speaks to the confidence Batum has in himself. He likes to catch and shoot, Jay, because it catches defenders off their guard.
Thompson, left side. Batum against Smith. And he gets the whistle. Two free throws coming up.
Oh, that's the tenacity of Smith. He's willing to get nasty inside, especially when he earns these type of fouls.
In games that came down to one possession last season, Chris, the Hornets won one but lost five.
Which is better than going winless in those games as they did the season before. But look, you have to have closers on your team, not just clutch players, but guys who can get their own shot against anyone.
And the first one drops.
Yeah, we know this guy Smith is one of the most fearless shooters in the game. I don't know if he's ever seen a shot he didn't like.
Smith hits them both. Walker with it. Picked up 24 points in their last win against the Pistons in Detroit.
Yeah, and don't forget about his passing. I mean, he didn't forget about his teammates. He was spreading the ball all over the floor.
Now here's Lamb. Great open look there. Williams has got himself going there. His first points of the game on the deep ball.
Well, during his career, Williams has been up and down shooting the three, but you at least got to crowd his airspace, not let him get a free look when he's firing.
Sexton. An amazing finish with a hand right in his face.
And giving up some height, he just finds a way to carve out a little separation.
Well, it takes a lot of confidence and toughness to make that play.
Now here's Zeller. 14 points from him the last game against Detroit.
Now don't forget his rebounding work, too. They couldn't contain him on the glass.
And it's off the back rim. No good.
You almost have to assume he's going to knock those down when he is that open.
Such incredible hops for a center. Look, it allows him to hold his own against any other five in the league.
Here's Walker. He's a player that you can only hope to slow down as he averages nearly 28 points a game. Count that bucket.
So crafty. The 6'1" Walker is skilled at getting the space he needs.
Now, here's Sexton, guarded by Walker. Thompson passes to Smith. And Sexton has it in the corner. Just five to shoot. Let's it go with a three. Zeller grabs the board. Charlotte has gone 2 of 2 from three-point range here in the first quarter. And Colin Sexton, when it comes to scoring, the man shows you a little bit of everything.
Loves to drive it, loves to attack inside, improving his consistency from range. But what I love about him is the aggressiveness. This guy is always in attack mode. And how sweet a play was that?
As sweet as it gets, an exquisite pass to set up the powerful alley-oop dunk. And a tremendous Unleash Chaos replay coming to you courtesy of Under Armour Hover Hammock. So Charlotte calls timeout. They're first. Greg, what are some of the positives that Tristan Thompson's play brings to the team?
Still a very efficient scorer on the shots that he does take. And he lives mostly inside the paint. And still a strong offensive rebounder. But his days of being a threat on the offensive end as the game has evolved seems to have kind of gone away.
And it's a completely new group on the floor for the Cavaliers. Parker against Clarkson. Takes the 13-footer, and that one's good. Parker.
Yeah, the mid-range jump shot is just automatic from Parker, especially when he gets the room to fire.
Harrison kicks to Zizic. And the pass to Cork. Misses the three.
Some very slack defending. Playing with fire to leave him that open beyond the arc.
Kept alive. At the top of the key, Hernan Gomez. Floats one, and it's Monk laying it in. Monk's got his first basket of the night.
Anytime Monk gets room to shoot, especially inside, he's such a crafty guard who you want to see pulling the trigger from inside.
Here's Zizic. Korver kicks to Harrison. Some nice passing by Cleveland here. And it's denied. They get it back. Korver, no luck. Charlotte leading by four. To the paint. Here's Kidd Gilchrist. And Kidd Gilchrist throws it down.
And Kidd Gilchrist is very skilled at throwing it down. The D can't allow him to get that close to the cup.
Harrison passes to Zizic. Here's Harrison. He just could not put it together in that loss to Chicago. Out of bounds. Charlotte takes possession. Here we are in November, and let's see how things are going out east in the early season as you take a look at Charlotte. Right there in fifth position, middle of the pack in the conference. And, of course, the Cavaliers, 5.5 games behind.
And checking out Charlotte, they're one of the NBA's early season success stories. They've made an immediate push toward the top of the standings.
Greg, I wish I could say I saw this coming, but I had no idea. They put it together so early. Tremendous job by the coaching staff.
Now, here's Monk. He's playing a pretty big role for him at the offensive end, averaging about 12.5 points a game.
Not easy to miss a clean look inside like that, but he manages to do it.
Here's Mwaba. Their offense, stone cold. Another miss there. Inside, Hernan Gomez kicks to Monk. Got a piece of it. From deep three-point range, that one doesn't drop. And so it's the Charlotte Hornets with a six-point lead at the end of the quarter. Their lead is where it is because they've gotten good shots. A lot of good shots. We've got more NBA basketball coming your way in just a minute. And for those of you just tuning in, the second quarter of action is where we're at right now. Looking at what we've seen from the Hornets, what do you think?
Listen, early on taking the league, I just like their approach offensively.
Yeah, right. Only the first quarter. Don't overpanic, but it seems like their strategy is working. We'll see if the other side can count.
And it's Parker with the ball, bringing it up for Charlotte. They host the 76ers after this game. They start a three-game homestand with that game. And a moment now to reset the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up for the second quarter of basketball. On the court for the Hornets, Parker and Monk, that's their backcourt. Bridges out there with Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And it's Hernan Gomez in at the five. And it's the Cavaliers with the ball, following the miss by Tony Parker. Mwaba passes to Harrison. Here's Zizic. Back to Harrison. And they call the foul, so he's got the and-one chance here to make it a three-point play.
What a play there. The hoop plus the harm.
First trip to the free-throw line for him tonight.
And a look back at his numbers from the free throw line last year, 78%, so not too bad.
Catching up on the changes for Cleveland. Tristan Thompson, he's checked in for Zizic. Nance comes in for David Nwaba, and it's Sexton in for Clarkson. Charlotte also making some changes. Zeller, he's checked in for Hernan Gomez. Batum comes in for Bridges, and Walker subbed in for Tony Parker. Chris, you've played in so many big moments, pressure-filled moments. When you look around the league, who are the guys, if you were coaching on their team, who are the guys you'd want to take the last shot? And I'm going to exclude yourself, because I know you'd like that last shot. But give me some guys who you could see doing it if you played with them.
Let's just go through the history. Let's go to KD and him coming down on that left side in the finals, shooting a three, walk-in dribble, shooting a tough three. And he's done that in two big games in the last few seasons. So let's go with KD. How about Steph? Let's go with his teammate Steph Curry from anywhere on the floor, hits you with big threes or layups. Then, okay, let's go to Harden out there in Houston. We know what he can do late in the game. And then if I just like a running one-hander to my left side, looking left and shooting right, and I'm floating off the top of the grass, I'm going to that man LeBron James at the last second. We got some great players in this league. It's great to be a fan, Kevin. There's some good basketball going on.
It is. We're lucky, huh? Yeah. Now, here's Sexton, following the miss by Kemba Walker. Sexton kicks to Thompson. Shot clock at 5. Out of bounds. Charlotte takes possession. And here's what the Cleveland Cavaliers schedule looks like. On Wednesday, they'll go up against Bradley Beal and the Washington Wizards. And then on Monday, they'll be matching up with Andre Drummond and the Detroit Pistons.
And Kevin, I think you have to look at this as an opportunity to take a step forward. Sometimes tough road trips can bring the best out of a team and bring you closer together.
Now, here's Monk. It's Kidd Gilchrist on the wing. Over Nance. Misses off the left iron.
There's a lesson for you. Don't showboat. Tries to get fancy with the fadeaway, and it backfires.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Kemba Walker helped lead UConn to a national title, but it took some time to hit his stride at the NBA level. He finally became an all-star, but his team is rebuilding in Charlotte. Mitch Kupchak is the new general manager, and James Borrego is the new head coach. Guys?
A terrific player, D.A., for sure. Thanks.
I like the guts of Walker. I mean, one of the smaller players in the league, but he still attacks the defense inside.
A terrific all-around player. Walker's improvement from range, Chris, has taken his game to another level.
Oh, yeah. He was much better inside the arc when he entered the league. But over his first four seasons, he shot around 31% from three. Then something clicked. Now, he's a factor.
Batum. Here's Zeller, laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Zeller's got his first points in this one.
And the work ethic of Zeller. Now that's what makes him dangerous when scoping out opportunities on the offensive glass.
So timeout called here, the first for Cleveland.
And look, when you watch Zeller play, his game is all about activity. He runs the floor extremely well for a seven-footer. And remember, he also registered one of the higher verticals at the combine the year he was drafted.
Smith checked in for Cleveland. Hood comes in for Harrison. Charlotte also making some changes. Williams comes in for Michael Kidd-Gilchrist. And Jeremy Lamb sub in for Monk. Batum against Smith. He kicks to Sexton. And Sexton slams it in.
And this is why you got to prevent Sexton from getting in the lane. Once he does, he just explodes towards the basket.
And Zeller drafted fourth overall. But to this point in his career, Chris, he's been mostly a role player.
Yeah, he needs to increase his shooting range the way that other bigs have. And even though he gives maximum effort every night, he has a hard time defending against quickness on the perimeter.
Now here's Lamb. He had 10 points in the win against Detroit. Williams trying to break free. Lamb, good. And the Hornets lead by 5.
Such a good in-between game. Lamb with the natural instincts from mid-range, plus the pure touch on the shot.
Sexton kicks to Hood. And Sexton has it in the corner. but they recover it. Over Walker. Here's Thompson. Persistence pays off as they finally hit a shot. Thompson's got his second basket of the night. Pass to Batum. Williams against Nance. Right side, Williams. Back to Batum. The Hornets need to get a shot off here. Walker's shot is off. The Cavaliers trail by three. Here's Sexton. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Rodney Hood. That'll be his second foul of the game. And the Cavaliers with some changes. Ante Zizic has checked in for Nance. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Sexton. And then for Charlotte, Hernan Gomez has checked in for Zeller. Bridges comes in for Nicholas Batum. And Parker subbed in for Walker. Parker against Clarkson. Parker kicks to Lamb. And Tristan Thompson gets the whistle that time. That is his first foul of the game. Seconds left in the first half of basketball. And it's Parker in the corner, just five on the clock. Over Thompson. And yep, finally drops after rolling around the rim. And the Hornets lead by five.
Yeah, now, almost any player left that wide open is going to bury that shot. This is the lead. That's poor defensive work.
Outside Hood. In the corner, it's Clarkson. For three, buries it from three-point range. Clarkson's got his first bucket of the game, and he's on the board for three. And that'll do it for the first half, a competitive game so far. Hornets lead by two. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Tony, you guys are flowing really well lately. When you guys are having success this year, what will it look like?
To stay healthy. I like our chances this year. Our young guys got a lot of experience, and we play good basketball right now, so hopefully we can stay healthy and play good at the end of the season.
That is always the most important thing for your team, Tony. Thanks a lot. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks so much, Dave, for the great interview. Don't go away, folks. We'll be back for the second half of basketball right after this.
The 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hey, everybody. Welcome back to the NBA on 2K Sports. This is our halftime show. Ernie Johnson, Shaquille O'Neal, Kenny the Jet Smith. After the first two quarters of play, it's Charlotte in control. They have a two-point lead. Kenny?
Well, there was a big spark from the bench in the first half. Sometimes you're hoping for your reserves to come in and just hold court, but they didn't do that. They actually got better.
Shaq, how do you think Cleveland played?
The thing I like was how they were making a conscious effort to work the ball inside. They should do the same in the second half. If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Whether running the offense through the post, driving it, doesn't matter. Get to the rim, and the rest will take care of itself.
And that's all we have for now. Tell the folks goodbye, Shaq. Tell the folks goodbye,
goodbye,
Kenny. Goodbye. Go to Kevin Harlan.
As we return a look at the corner of Euclid and East 6th in downtown Cleveland, just a few blocks from our spot here at Quicken Loans Arena. Second half of basketball upon us. We may be in for an exciting finish based on how close of a game it's been so far. You gotta like what Nicholas Batum has done in this game.
But really, the numbers aren't gaudy. They don't stick out, but his energy and impact does.
You're right. Go in the locker room, ask anyone on his team. He's not worried about statistics as much as he is about winning.
And after a fairly even first couple of quarters, the second half could turn out to be a great one as both teams try to gain an edge. Nance and Thompson are up front. Sexton is out there with Hood, and it's Smith in at the three spot. That's the five for Cleveland right now. Here's Lamb, and Lamb slams it home.
Great leaping ability. Gets off the floor very quickly. This is why coach wants Lamb to attack the rim more often.
Smith outside.
Who's watching him?
From the line, Zeller grabs the board. Zeller's got four rebounds now tonight. Batum finds Williams. Basket is good. He'll get a chance for one more at the line.
Well, when Batum, Kevin, spots a wide-open teammate, he zips the rock to him quickly. Just exceptional vision.
Always a solid all-around player. Marvin Williams' improvement from range has made him a little more dangerous.
Well, think about this. Over his first three seasons, he shot under 30% from distance. That's not good. But in recent seasons, he shot over 40% a couple times. That's great.
Mind the
That'll keep you relevant
Mind
in today's game.
One shot.
When it comes to video review, C-Web, do you feel the NBA has done a good job of incorporating it into the flow of the game, or is there, in your opinion, still some work to be done in this regard?
There's a little work to be done. I mean, nothing's ever perfect, but I think they've done a great job. I mean, you want to get it right, and so there's going to be a little bit of an inconvenience sometimes in going back to it. The main thing for me is to make sure that it's as fast as possible, that you're not giving the team extra time to get together and to huddle up and to call plays. You're not taking the rhythm away from a team that just went on a 10-0 run, and now they have to sit on the side for 2 minutes in real time and see if this call is correct. So the speed that is done with the video review is the only thing I think that needs to be worked on, and that's going to be situation to situation. So I think the NBA is doing a really good job.
Good points.
And of the last six baskets, five have come on the interior. This is just smash-mouth physical basketball, guys.
Now here's Thompson. Smith drives in. Kicks it to Sexton. And another miss by Cleveland.
0 for 3 now since halftime. Taking them a little while to find their rhythm.
Passes it to Lamb. Nance against Williams. Pass to Lamb. Fires the three. Rebound by Smith. And it's Smith with the ball. He brings it up for Cleveland. Still looking for their first bucket of the second half.
It doesn't take much to impact his shot. I mean, even at point blank range.
Here's Lamb. The shot's good on the assist by Walker. Walker's got his third assist on the night.
He spots up so well off the ball. Lamb, an excellent all-around jump shooter.
Timeout called, Cleveland. One thing that's added a little pressure to Lamb's development, Chris, his link to James Harden.
Maybe the most important trade piece received back from Harden. I mean, it's taken Lamb a while to develop. He's coming around, though, but Harden, of course, I mean, he was perennial MVP candidate.
The Cavaliers with some changes. Kyle Korver, he's checked in for Nance. David Mwaubot comes in for J.R. Smith. And it's Harrison in for Hood. Charlotte also making some changes. Michael Kidd-Gilchrist comes in for Marvin Williams. And Monks subbed in for Jeremy Lamb. Now, here's Sexton. He provides a good amount of offense for the team, averaging around 11.5 points a game. Here's Harrison. And he can't stop the run as he misses.
Oof, ugly start to the second half. They're still scoreless in their first five attempts.
Monk, no one around him, and it's off from three-point range. Now, here's Sexton, guarded by Walker. Shoot. Harrison passes to Corver. Launches a three, and the three ball is good.
If you do not respect that Kyle Corver has been making a living as a sniper from deep, then you haven't been doing your studying. You don't know the scout report.
Now here's Walker. There's the pass to Monk. Outside Batum, he kicks to Walker. From deep three-point range, it's rebounded by Cleveland. Thompson's got six rebounds here tonight.
And look, if he can start turning some of these misses into makes, their lead is going to take a big jump.
And there's a minute 45 left in the third quarter. Pass to Harrison. And there's the call on Cody Zeller. That is his first foul of the game. And the Cavaliers with some changes. Zizic comes in for Thompson. And it's Jordan Clarkson in for Harrison. And then for Charlotte, Hernan Gomez is checked in for Zeller. Bridges comes in for Nicholas Batum. And Parker subbed in for Kemba Walker. Now, here's Clarkson. They've been leaning on him for a decent chunk of their offense. He's averaging over 15 points a game. And it's good off the back rim and in. Clarkson's got five now.
You see the poise developing in Clarkson. He makes a nice choice in the pick and roll.
Hernan Gomez kicks to Parker. It's Kid Gilchrist on the wing. Passes it to Monk. From the arc, drains the three-pointer. He has five.
And Monk has proven that he is a terrific scorer from the perimeter. When he's in rhythm, he has no problem letting it fly.
Here's Zizic. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Sexton dishes to Clarkson. Kicks it to Sexton. And another three for Cleveland.
Boy, they've been terrific from beyond here in the second. If they play it right, we're talking a two for one.
Exactly, but you still want a decent look because if you miss, the strategy doesn't help.
Now here's Kid Gilchrist. Can't cash in on the 10-foot jumper. There's 21 seconds left to play in the third. Now, here's Sexton, guarded closer. And Nwaba has it in the corner. Outside Corver. Hits the three-point bomb. Corver's got six in the quarter.
Yeah, that catch-and-shoot game of Corver is lethal. His ability to immediately fire off the pass is good as it gets.
And we just finished the third quarter, and we've got a tight ball game here. It's Charlotte. They lead by three. And we're just moments away from the start of the fourth quarter. Stay with us. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
Just true artistry right there. I mean, great decision on where to go with the ball, and how about the perfect delivery?
How about the unselfishness? Night in and night out, we see guys trying to force their own agenda. Not that time.
And it's been a very competitive game so far as we get rolling here in quarter number four. The Cavaliers trail by three, and on the court for Charlotte as we start the fourth. Bridges and Williams, your forward pair. Jeremy Lamb out there with Parker. And it's Hernan Gomez in at the center, filling out the middle. Now, here's Clarkson. Oh, Nance in position. Hammers the alley-oop through.
So good at scoring off the pick and roll. That time, Clarkson with the perfect setup.
And a tremendous Unleash Chaos replay coming to you courtesy of Under Armour Hover Havoc. Parker finds Hernan Gomez. Now here's Lamb, covered by Hood. Lamb passes to Parker. Charlotte moving the ball around. Fires for three. Good. The nice assist for Williams. And it's 7 points for Parker.
Yeah, Parker's ability to stretch it, it really forces the defense to contest him from out there.
Clarkson looking for an opening. Top of the key. That shot misses. And Charlotte will go the other way with it. They've led by as many as 11 points. On the wing, Lamb, covered by Hood. And he drops in the layup off the glass. And it's a 6-point Charlotte lead.
And able to get it done once again in close. Just one of the ultimate finishers at the rim.
Pass to Zizic. Now the pass to Clarkson. Good D by Parker.
Some tough D in the paint. Getting between him and the bucket and stopping the easy D.
Up top, Hernan Gomez. Pass to Bridges. He kicks it to Lamb. Parker against Clarkson. Puts one up from 19. No good on the shot. A bit long that time.
I don't care who it is. You can't leave him wide open from that range.
To the inside. Out to Hood. And another miss by Cleveland.
Well, defensively, they could have done better. That's an open look he'd like to have back.
Bridges shot. Good.
Timeout.
Just so precise off the pass. I like how Bridges prepares himself to shoot as the ball is coming his way.
And the Cavaliers call time here. Guys, Jeremy Lamb, 2 years at UConn, drafted by the Thunder, but he's come into his own with the Hornets.
Yeah, and what some exec call the second draft, finding young players who, for whatever reason, haven't been able to make an impact with their first team, sometimes that changes scenery and ability to mature can do wonders for a player.
Thompson, he's checked in for the Cavaliers. The Hornets also changing it up. Cody Zeller's checked in for Hernan Gomez. Batum comes in for Bridges, and it's Kemba Walker in for Tony Parker. All right, let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Thanks, guys. I got a chance to hear what the Cavaliers head coach was saying to his team. He said, guys, we look like we're running in mud. Let's get out and see the early offense. And if it's not there, let's run the half-court offense. Pretty good advice, Kevin.
And here's Hood following Jeremy Lamb's three. Hood kicks to Clarkson. Cleveland needs to get a shot off here. Here's Nance, and there's another one for the Cavaliers.
Yeah, this league is in good shape when you talk about guys like Nance. The consummate role player does everything that's asked of him.
Now here's Walker. Inside, here's Lamb. Throws it down as the official calls the foul. It may be a 3-point play. It's going to be on Rodney Hood.
And a sturdy screen set for him that time. And he doesn't fool around, just straight to the rim for the finish.
No way for his man to get around that one. That's for sure.
And that's a play they'll run over and over, fellas, as long as he keeps working.
And the Cavaliers making a change here. Sexton's checked in.
What's up?
Free throw drops for Lamb.
Now, after that great college tournament, we all remember Jeremy Lamb performing in. Lamb was drafted 12th overall by the Rockets, but his career had a bit of a seesaw for a while.
Now, here's Sexton. Let's it go from 14. A second chance effort. Good on the shot. And with that, the Charlotte lead is cut down now to just 8 points with the basket from Nance. And it's Walker with the ball, bringing it up for Charlotte. They've given up just 8 points in the fourth quarter. Passes it to Lamb. Kicks it to Zeller. Shot clock at 6. Over Thompson. A nice shot by Zeller. And the Hornets lead by 10.
Well, in college, Zeller showed great ability to face up and knock down mid-range jumpers. He's just now doing it more consistently in the pros.
Now, here's Sexton. Smith outside. Rebound by Williams. And here's Charlotte. They're on a 15-6 run.
and it looks like just playing the last bit of this one out in what should be a nice win here for Charlotte.
They found a great rhythm from long range.
Yeah, Kevin, every time they left a man open deep, he'd get a good shot at the basket. Didn't hesitate, and that aggression paid off.
And with this effort tonight, grabbing their eighth win of the year.
And as we get set to put this one to bed, a one-sided season series thus far, they've won two straight.
And a great team effort tonight, helped in large part with contributions and the nice night it ended up being for Lamb.
He was the alpha dog out there tonight, totally in charge of this game. No matter what the situation was, he was the one to dictate the action.
Presentation of our Jordan Player of the Game, Jeremy Lamb.
And he's just been crushing it from the field tonight, Kevin. Whether it's been on open looks or with the guy draped all over him, he just hadn't missed much. With his percentage in the sky-high range, they've had no choice but to make him their number one option on every trip.
Teams need contributions from everybody to win on the road, not just the stars. And he's done more than his share tonight, an outstanding performance. Now, here's Walker. Kyle Korver missing his last shot. Walker finds Zeller. Now, Bridges. From 13, Cavaliers with the rebound. Here's Nwaba. Over Bridges. No good. So no problem for Charlotte as they get the win. They came in here and took care of business like they were the home team.
And Kevin, how about the mental toughness that this group showed? They were never rattled at all by the opposing fans.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Thanks very much. Tony, what was going good for you offensively tonight?
I think the ball movement was great tonight. But I think the main thing for us is to play great defense. Defensively, we have to be at our best, and everybody has to help, and I think tonight we did a great job.
Really got it going when you needed to. Thanks, Tony. Back to you, Kevin.
David, thank you as always. And that'll do it, folks. For Greg Anthony, Chris Webber, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching the NBA, presented by 2K Sports. See you later.